Here we are again, this time with Aaron Brophy on sax and Daniel Kern on theremin. I'm playing my large aluminum bell plate here, just creating long tones, letting them fade out. The music is moving slowly, so I don't want to hurry it along at all. Add a bit of wind gong in there. And then a Michael Paiste water gong. I've just created a very slow, deliberate pace here. I'm playing a trigon, which is made by Martin Blass in Germany. We're keeping the slow pace of letting the metal ring out. And I can spin it to get that nice warbling Doppler effect. I want you to notice the pitch of the instruments I'm playing and how they fit in to the music. None of my instruments here are tuned to specific Western pitches. Now I'm playing a pair of drobu bells, and I've taken the clappers out of them. That way I can shake them, as you see, getting a nice vibrato sound. Wand like singing bowls and rub around the edge to get a sustained tone. Still keeping the pace slow and still, choosing pitches that fit into the notes that the other two are playing. Now adding some kaizi, also known as Burma bells, those little pagoda-shaped bell plates on the end there. Keeping the pace slow, letting the music unfold as opposed to trying to push it. I think a problem we have as drummers is we are often used to just making the music go. Especially if you were playing drum set, you've kind of never stopped. You just keep going and going. Here's a percussionist. I'm more able to pace myself. And especially with the metal, letting things vibrate, fade away, and then strike them again. Thank you. as always, I'm listening. So if the other musicians were to change the pace, start playing quicker notes, shorter notes, things like that, I would adjust. But we all seem to be in the same frame of mind.